So I have a Tuesday morning haul. I've been kind of holding off on filming this because when I went to Tuesday morning, I only bought three things and I didn't feel that it warranted a video. So that was about 2 weeks ago that I went. So today, after my eye exam, I dropped by to see if they had any stuff, any new stuff. But I didn't really see anything new, but I did see some clearance. So let's go ahead and get started. And don't mind my hand if you happen to see this. Long story, I might tell you. I might tell it at the end of this video. So anyways, I did find some more Graphic 45. These are the single sheet packs, you know, 25 in a pack. So this one right here is from the Life's a Journey collection. So this is the front, I guess, or actually this would be the front. It's called Take Time. Love this print, the purple flowers, and then of course the back is purple with the lettering. Then I have this one right here also. Well, this one is actually called from Lost in Paradise collection. So we've got this really nice kind of summery look, florals. But this one is why I bought it, just beautiful. I mean, I don't do full page layout, but it's just so beautiful. Any part that you would cut up is still gonna be, you know, really nice. So we got that. I did find today, I've been passing this up, but you know, finally just went ahead and gave in. So this is from Simple Stories. It's the Country Christmas collection. So you get the paper, the cut aparts, the stickers, and then you also get the layered frames, which I love. So I'm gonna really try to make use of these when Christmas comes up. Also you got some numbered pocket pieces here. This actually would be really good for a December daily. In fact, they had the matching binder for this, but it wasn't marked down. It was still like, I think it was $12 or $9.99. I'm gonna wait for that to get marked down. They had two of them, and if they mark it down, then I'll go ahead and get one or two. I don't know, we'll see. I finally picked this one up. I'd been, you know, putting it back every time because it was like, it was marked down, I think, to $3, and now it's marked down to $1.57, which is an amazing deal. And I liked it for this part right here because I can use that in my traveler's notebooks, you know, as the background, especially, I don't know, I just liked the look of this. And then of course, like this is the other side, which is a really nice color, you know. So it's another single pack of 25, okay. So I got all of these paper packs here. And then I did pick up another one of the Life's a Journey, Not a Destination, the Ephemera pack for $3.99. can see. And then the big score was this one right here. It was weird because I saw this at $2.77, but then there was one right next to it that was still marked for like, I think it was like $6 or something like that. And I didn't understand why that one was still marked more expensive than this. This is the Jane Davenport. The these are the brushes. I don't really know what the big deal is about this. It's a magnetic brush set, includes four brushes in perfect sizes to easily store in a metal cube. Now, I wasn't really intending on getting it, but for $1.57, I can try them out, you know. So I'm gonna open this up because and see why. I hope there's nothing missing from it. It was sealed, so come on. I hate it when it's so hard to open stuff up, you know, and then you end up having to destroy the packaging, and then what, you end up wanting to return it. Destroyed packaging. Okay, here we go. And this is heavy. It's a regular $8.99. so what, really? Okay. I mean, what is the big deal? Oh, okay, so they can stand up. I see. So, wow. Really? That's it? $1.77, I meant $2.77. Okay. I guess, I don't know. I could probably make use of this with something else. I mean, the brushes are nice, you know. So these are supposed to be blending brushes. I'm gonna have to look at some videos. I remember people talking about this when Jane Davenport had released these, but yeah, I don't know. I might return it. Because I thought this was going to be like an actual case, you know, that you could, what do you call it? That you could like store them in, not just like a display case. That's kind of stupid, I think. I mean, really? Yeah. I mean, it's really heavy, but I don't know. We'll see. We shall see. So anyways, that's my little haul from Tuesday morning. It just sucks because they're not getting a lot of stuff in, you know? And then I see other people getting new stuff at their Tuesday mornings. I don't know what's going on. Tuesday morning, come on, get your shit together, okay? So I did say I might tell the story about how this happened, okay? I'm not gonna show my knees. So I went to the DMV to get the real ID done, you know? And as I was getting out of my car, I took my glasses off to wipe them down because living in the South, it's humid. And as I was wiping them, I did not see this little metal piece protruding from the ground, about maybe 2 inches off the ground. And I tripped on it. And yes, I fell down. Fortunately, I didn't smash my glasses, but I literally fell down like face down almost. I didn't get hurt on my face. A woman who was parking saw me fall and immediately was yelling if I was okay, but I was just so stunned at what happened. So when I rolled over, I was like, oh my God, my hand was like bleeding, okay? And she came over and she helped me get up. And you know, I didn't even know what I tripped over. And then she saw it first and she was shocked. She's like, I can't believe they didn't put a cone over that. So apparently what it was is like where they would put a metal sign, it was square shaped. And I'll try to see if I can insert a picture, because I did take a picture. It was like left over from where they had like the metal sign. I guess if they were gonna put another one, they would just slide it right in. I mean, they should have put something there, you know, like a cone, you know, so that people would walk around it. So I walked into the DMV with my hands bleeding, and I went to the bathroom and washed off, because there was debris on my hand. And so when I got up to the counter and I asked them if they had a Band-Aid or something, the lady at the counter was more concerned about the fact that I didn't have an appointment than about my hand bleeding on her counter. You know, and at that point I was just like, I'm already here. This is the second time I've come this week. I finally brought all of the requirements to get the real ID. And I was like, I'm not gonna go home. So so she gave me the ticket. I sat down, I sat there for an hour with my hands and my knees, because I have scrapes above my knee, on my left knee and on my right, with my hands and knees like burning. Okay, by the time I got to the counter, you know, all it took was 5 minutes to get my new driver's license with the real ID on it. And then, you know, after that, I immediately walked out, took pictures of the parking lot of where that piece was so that I could file a complaint with the state, you know? So, and I went straight home because I was like, I had all these other plans that I was gonna, you know, errands that I was gonna do, but I had to go home because I needed to like treat my hands and my knees because they were just burning. So get home only to find that my Neosporin that I had was expired. So I had to go to Walmart and buy new Neosporin, you know, and then come back home, you know, put a big bandage on here, and then took some ibuprofen because by then my knee, my right knee especially, was starting to swell. And it was still hurting. But, you know, I was kind of like, I'm going to walk it off because I still need to see if I can get an eye exam. So I did go to Walmart to see if they had any walk-ins available. and they did not, but I scheduled one for today, which I did go to. But anyways, like all last night, I went to bed early and I didn't know that I probably had strained my ribs on my right side from when I fell, because it started hurting like a couple hours before I went to bed, which is weird. So I couldn't lie down on my right side. So I probably spent a good 2 hours like tossing and turning before I finally fell asleep. But I felt much better in the morning. Although my ribs hurt, you know, when I was getting up, my knee didn't hurt as much. But I still went ahead and took some ibuprofen. I always try to avoid taking ibuprofen as much as possible because I don't want my body to get accustomed to it. I've been on like massive doses of prednisone before, so I try to avoid anything that's anti-inflammatory, but I mostly try to avoid taking ibuprofen because when I need it to work, I want it to work. You know what I mean? I don't want my body to get used to it. So this is like now been, 2 days in a row, but I've only taken like 2 pills for the whole day. I know it only lasts like 4 to 6 hours, but like I said, I try not to take too much of it. So today it was much better. I really tried to walk it off. The swelling has gone down. The skin is starting to heal, so it's not so bad. But here I actually had to like take my cuticle clippers and kind of clip off the dried skin that was sticking up because it would catch on stuff. So, but I've been applying, the Neosporin on it, and I didn't want to put a bandage on because I really wanted to heal a lot faster. This part right here, I don't know what the heck. I think the blood, the skin had already healed before or something. I don't know. It's just strange. But anyways, I'm just glad that I didn't really hurt my hands, you know, so that I'll be able to type and write. But so kind of sucked that that happened. But hopefully I'll get a response from the state. I'm not looking for any money or anything. I just want them to fix that little piece that's in the parking lot so it doesn't happen to somebody else, especially with the number of elderly people that I saw that were walking in, you know, to get like their license or whatnot. I mean, can you imagine if one of them had fallen in the parking lot? We're talking about, you know, probably hip replacement or what, you know? So, gonna go ahead and send that complaint off with the pictures. But anyways, so this was that's my little story for today, and this was my Tuesday morning call. And I hope y'all have a good week or a good weekend, depending on when I upload this. All right, take care, bye-bye.